Happy New Year, Gordon.
Happy New Year to you too, Stephen. It's a lovely evening in Auckland this evening, quite warm, and the ground is looking very, very hard indeed for tonight's fixture. Round 13 of the NSL, a new year, a new defence. Is it a new approach for the tormented Kings? We're into round 13, as I said, and the race for the top six heats up as of now. And if the Kings are to stay alive in 2002, they'll have to take advantage of the 8 home games they have on this side of the season to make any progress up the table. To kick that off, they don't count much tougher than the Olympic Sharks, fresh from that 3-1 victory over the runaway NSL leaders, the Perth Glory, just 2 weeks ago. So it'll be Paul Urlovich and Andy Vlahos to kick things off for the Kings, playing in their all-black outfit against the Sharks in the all-white. And this will be a big, big test for the Kings. A new defence, much reorganised, with big John Markoski in the centre of the back three, which also includes his captain Chris Jackson, and the return of Sean Douglas. We haven't seen Douglas since he went off with that hamstring strain in that 7-2 rout against Perth Glory in round 4. So that will certainly be one of the major talking points from tonight's game, as the Kings get the first free kick. Theokotos getting distance. And the Sharks will take the throw in. Lindsay Wilson, the man who's played in every game for the Sharks this season. Good throw down the line. Douglas. Here is the captain, Chris Jackson. Cool ball from Jackson. Halpin. Carl gives it back to his captain, Troy Halpin. And he won't be happy with his delivery either. Nice stats online, skytv.co.nz, if you want to keep up with those statistics. So Perry with the throw. Kings lead the head-to-head between these two sides, 3-1. They certainly surprised the Sydney Olympic, as it was then. In the first season, the Kings were involved in this league with back-to-back wins, both in Sydney and in Auckland. And they shared the games last season, the Kings losing 2-0 in Sydney, but winning here in Auckland by a goal to nil. So they'll be looking to extend that good form against this Olympic side, who will be really hoping to push on in 2002. And they talked about a grand final contestant, with Perth perhaps being the other team in that grand final.
Yeah, it's really a critical stage of the season now, and all the teams coming back nice and fresh after having a couple of weeks off over the Christmas period. I'm sure they'll be very keen to get back and grab the 3 points early on in this first game in 2002. And you know what it's like, Freddie. It's always nice to get a couple of weeks off, freshen the legs up and come back with a positive outlook to things. And I'm sure the Kings will be looking for that one tonight.
Yeah, and especially with the players have probably had a bit of time to reflect on what's happened in the first few months of the season. And I think individually, every one of them's got to just say, what do I want to get out of this season as an individual and as a team?
Nata. Good possession football from the Kings. Markoski using his keeper. First time we've seen Markoski in the defensive role. And his option was to go back to the keeper.
Probably the first time he's ever done that in his life.
Juric. Jackson. Nata. Always available for the ball, Harry Nata. Burton. Got some space to operate in, Mark Burton. Vlahos just stays onside. Muscled off the ball by Andrew Durante, and it'll be a goal kick.
I think it's probably important tonight too for Markoski at the back there, Freddie. You know what it's like as a striker, sort of running around and trying to shift the the other two defenders, that he gives himself a little bit of time, a little bit of space, and he gets Sean Douglas and Chris Jackson tonight, get them employed as the markers, and just give himself a little bit of freedom so he can pull the strings a little bit at the back there and get things organised, use his experience, and lead the players through.
And also it depends how they play, whether they go man on man with Douglas and Jackson, or they play zonally. I think against Newcastle a couple of games ago they were a bit at sea when they played zonally. I think it'd probably be a better option to go man on man.
Nick Carr just went past Chris Jackson as if he wasn't there, and that's a real danger sign for the Kings defence, because Carr is a very, very exciting player. The man who just can't control the ball there. But he will torment this Kings defence all night. Made his debut, the Olympic number 19, as a 15-year-old. And has already scored 3 goals this season, Nick Carr. And he left Chris Jackson in his wake on the right-hand touchline. Douglas. Nice control from Vlahos. Campbell getting an early touch. Good to see him back in a Kings shirt as well. Didn't have much joy at Adelaide. Carr dropping deep again to get involved in the play and pick up possession for Olympic.
He's certainly going to get a side in an Olympic that'll come at the Kings. Very, very attacking side. The fullbacks like to get forward. And even the two stoppers like to get themselves involved in the game, pressing into midfield and getting the attack started.
Here's Jackson. A lot of space opening up for him, looking for Vlahos. The ball wasn't a good one from Jackson. The attack breaks down. Had plenty of time to look up and size up the options, Chris Jackson. His delivery into the penalty area was poor. Vlahos is frustrated.
Encouraging to see though, Gordon, that Lees Jackson, as you see here, great. He's prepared to come forward with the ball, and I think that's been previously that, you know, they've stopped and gone backwards. He's come forward, he's looked for the advancing Vlahos. And again, it was just that, you know, that final ball into the box, it's cost them. But good to see that they're positive and looking to do things coming from the back.
And also a couple of good balls from George Gutsoulis early on, just switching play and giving Chris Jackson the opportunity to go forward there by opening up the field for him.
Carl looking for some work early on. You just see on the ball,
nice
he's
touch.
Gone round 3 defenders. And his ball over the top, offside. But a lovely player to watch as we see Nick Pozewski just going offside. New man making his first start this season for the Olympic Sharks.
That certainly could be a key feature tonight, is Nick Carl's ability to come deep into midfield, pick up balls and look for the advancing midfielders to be played in over the top. And that's certainly going to be effective for Jackson, Douglas and Markowski tonight to take care of.
Halpin. Gutsoulis. Little touch too much for Nata. Might get another touch. Gutsoulis will bite into the tackles. Vlahos gets it down on the deck for Gutsoulis to use, and he uses his keeper. So Olympic have made the top 4 in the last couple of years. Kings, of course, have finished 8th in both those seasons. Here's Pozewski from some distance, just dragging his shot wide and getting an ironic cheer from the... It's not a bad crowd here at Ericsson for January the 4th. Next, Pozewski, former Marconi junior, has spent the last couple of years playing in Belgium and makes his first appearance on the Olympic team sheet this evening. Playing up front alongside Nick Carl. Well, they haven't conceded many this season, Olympic. Just 8 goals, and they've only conceded more than 1 goal on one occasion. That was in a 2-2 draw with Parramatta Power. But they're up against a team that has the second best scoring record in the Football Kings, even though they lie bottom of the table. It it's that defence that's been a concern for the Kings all season. And Kevin Fallon, the coach, has got rid of the defence that lost three goals against Adelaide in their last outing and replaced them with three new faces. In an attempt to shore things up, there is Kevin Fallon.
There again, Gordon, if the Kings can get on the board first, then I think straight away Sydney Olympic, well, Olympic Sharks, you know, they look at their goal-scoring record and go, well, you know, we can't score that many, so, you know, the pressure goes back on them straight away. Because the way they're going, they only score one goal a game.
Well, the Kings don't score many goals in the first half. They've only scored two this season in the first 45 minutes of the 17 they've scored.
Do you know how many they conceded in the first half of Gordon?
They've conceded 13 in the first half, so of the 29 conceded, 13 have got in the first 45 minutes, so you, if you're going to see a goal this half, I'd put your money on the Olympic Sharps getting it, but help him with the free kick. North holding off Campbell. North. Now a chance for Ilovich. It's 2-on-2. Vlahos making the run down the centre if Ilovich can find him, but just unable to control the pass. But certainly Olympic looking to push forward.
Yeah, they will, and I think Ante Zurich, we just saw a couple of minutes ago, Gordon, quite prepared to come from the back in a sweeper's position and get involved in midfield and start getting things going forward. And, you know, Wilson again, poor delivery, but, you know, early signs that the fullbacks are going to start to attack. But great little move there from the Kings. Just Jonathan Perry on the far side, who was just off screen, was perhaps just a little late coming into the attack, though, Freddie, but at least he's starting to look forward to, you know, get the numbers up there.
Yeah, I mean, it's not only Jonathan Perry. You know, that's one thing where I think the central defender, like Juric, is invaluable. Someone who's prepared to run past the strikers and make the extra man, and then allows other midfielders, strikers, to make runs off that. And that's why a player like him is just is a pain in the neck for a striker, I'll tell you.
To be fair, you like to go forward a little bit from the back too. It's not always flash day back there, but no, very talented player.
So just over 11 minutes on the clock at Ericsson. It's 0-0 between the Kings and the Olympic Sharks. Olympic coming into this game in fourth place in the table. They have 17 points. 5 points adrift of the team in third, but here's a chance for the Sharks. Good save by Theokletos, and McCoskey puts it away for the corner. Pondoliak has scored two this season already for the Sharks and made a lot of headway through the Kings midfield. And we have said all season that Theokletos is a good shot stopper, and he proved it once again.
Yeah, there's certainly that dividing line of when you come out to shut the players down, and not one Kings player has come this time. They've left it a little bit too late, and Theokletos just catching that one on his legs.
Corner swinging in, dangerous one. And I don't know that Theokletos knew too much about it, but it shaved his back post, and he'll be happy to take the goal kick.
He's got this nasty habit of going forward first before the ball's played. And then if the ball goes over his head, or, you know, someone gets in his way, he's too far forward and he has to make ground back. And it's very, very difficult once you've committed forward to make up that ground backwards again. And it's something he's got to work on. Just wait on his line, and once he knows he's going to get it, come and just pluck it out of the air.
What was it, Fred?
Bozeski working hard. North. Easy for Gitsoulis. Now Burton. Haven't seen a lot of Mark Burton this season. Certainly had a quieter season than he did last year. Douglas keeping it in. Campbell looking to take the throw. Nice touch by Urlovic. Now Burton has got help from Urlovic. He's had a good season this year, Paul Urlovic. 6 goals to the number 9. Well, this Olympic team has some New Zealand connections. Ricky Herbert, you once played for them.
Yeah, thoroughly enjoyed it, Gordon. Wee while ago, 1983, but we had a good year, won the cup that season, and Gary Phillips, the coach of the side now, was very much a big part of that side, as was the CEO, Peter Roscopoulos.
And Robbie Ironside, a former All Whites captain, played 175 games for Olympic, scoring 39 goals. And Clint Gosling, who we saw here last home game as manager of the Newcastle side, he played 89 times in goal for Olympic. So a real Kiwi connection with this club.
You're really passionate too, and a club that likes attacking football and has produced some pretty good players over the years. And this side is shaping into title contenders at this halfway stage of the season.
So Bolton getting good distance on his goal kicks, and Markowski knocks it back into the melting pot with Vlahos after it. It's easy though for Bolton. Man on the verge of maybe going to the World Cup this year with the Socceroos if they'd made it. He was certainly in consideration by Frank Farina for one of the goalkeeping spots. Ponoyak looking to take on Markowski. A striker, come defender, goes to ground. And the referee has seen an infringement in the box. Just a sight there that Markowski perhaps lunging in a bit too quickly.
He's got to hold his ground here, doesn't he? Great run from Pondoliak out of midfield. And as the two strikers had gone wide, he's turned Markowski, and John, you've got to stand on your legs there and just make him play backwards again. Stop the cross.
Ideally, I'd like to see him just anchoring that middle of the park, really, Freddie, and getting a midfielder to drop, or one of the other stoppers picking up in those wide positions, because it's certainly the height factor that's been costing the Kings on a couple of occasions we've seen this year, so they certainly need John back in the middle there to defend those.
Yeah, but I think Ponoliak could run past his midfielder, so, I mean, as the sweeper, he's got to come out and he's got to pick him up. So, I mean, yeah, ideally, you know, obviously Harry Nader or George Gutsoulis would go with the runner, but, no, that's Markowski's job if they don't.
Well, Lindsay Wilson hobbling a bit, doesn't want to get attention, but he looks in a bit of trouble. Carr, two Kings players, three Kings players around them, looks to take the ball on and gets past them. Not quite, gets in the cross though. Wasiewski and Pondoliak just getting in each other's way somewhat. And Markowski clears up, no frills about the clearance, just puts it into some space and relieves the pressure on the Kings defence. But Nick Carr again, causing a few worries.
He's giving them a bit too much respect, I think, there, eh, Ricky?
Yeah, I guess he's one of those players, too, that, you know, he's got a great reputation in the league, and he is a talented, very, very outstanding player, and I think probably one or two of the Kings defenders are giving him a little bit too much respect. I think he's going to do something on the ball and beat them, and he has on a couple of occasions, but it's important that they really shut them down, though.
Yep.
No respect there from Jackson on Carl. And a half minutes gone, no score. Game is really a bit of a dogfight in midfield in these opening stages.
There again on that challenge, good place to put in a heavy challenge on a striker. You know, on the halfway line, you know, not much going to happen there. You know, you're not under any pressure, so you know, go in with a lot of force, just let them know you're there.
So possession in favour of the Olympic Sharks in this early stage of the match. Another free kick for the Kings, taken quickly by Gutsoulis. Perry loses out, gives the ball up to Troy Halpin. Carr. Wasiewski. Durante coming forward. Black stayed down. Halpin gets the cross in. Diokotos has come and got it. Good keeping in the end from Diokotos. And Durante stayed down. Baby got a boot in the face as he went down.
It was well played by the Sharks. Nice and tight in there. And Jeff Campbell had just dropped behind the line to fake Troy Halpin on this occasion on an offside position. Onside position, should I say. And Theocritus having to come under the big challenge of the Olympic players. And I think just a little stray foot there, Freddie.
Yep.
But he's trying to free himself, I think, of the tangled players.
Worrying sign there, though, that as that cross came in, there were three Olympic players on the back post. And all the Kings defenders had gone to the near post.
Erlovich.
Again, it's the marking at the back. If the cross had been a little bit deeper and gone over Theocritus's head, I mean, would have been just a simple tap-in.
Juric. Leaves it for Halpin. Halpin again. Pulling the strings. Carl comes very deep to get himself involved. Nice run forward from Wilson. Good cross in. Dangerous. It's gone past everybody. And Perry will be able to shovel it away for a throw-in. But a lovely move from Olympic. And that caused all sorts of problems in the goal area for the Kings.
Well, Wilson getting forward from the right fullback position. And he's looked to do that on a number of times. Quality ball in there that had had the Kings scrambling. Well, there's certainly another player to look out for tonight is Troy Halpin. This guy's an exceptional player. Number of times he's picked the ball up in the back three and then he's appeared at the far post or he's crossing things in and setting play up in that attacking third. Really exciting to watch and he just picks and chooses his times to do it, but he's doing it very, very effectively.
You can see the pattern, can't you? See Nick Carl, Pasewski drops deep, and then it's open slather for the midfielders to get forward and make up the numbers up front. So, you know, don't be alarmed to see Nick Carl on the halfway line just twisting and turning, and then seeing the midfielders just streaming into the box.
They're coming up to the halfway point in the first half. Still no score, although Olympic have had the better of the opportunities. The Kings really need to get something out of this match. And not really a draw. A draw won't lift them anywhere. A win could lift them a couple of spots. But with 8 home games in this part of the season, we're now at the end of the round robin. They certainly have to take advantage of them. It's a team that's low in confidence. Results haven't gone their way. Games they should have got points in. They've seen them snatched from them in the closing stages. We've seen 2 on this ground. The last 2 occasions they played here. The 2-2 draw with Newcastle just before Christmas. With the win snatched off them, with virtually the last kick of the game, and the 3-2 loss to Northern Spirit 2 weeks prior to that. Kings led 2-1 with 10 minutes to go, and lost 3-2.
I think he had his shirt there.
Yeah, Gutierrez and Pondolak.
So Carl and Halpin deciding what to do with this free kick. 3-man wall for the Kings with Tom Pondolak making a nuisance of himself just in front of it. It's Halpin, and it's a good header. And it's been dragged just wide. It wasn't a clear header on goal. There was the defender doing his duty.
Certainly a difficult one to defend, and it's Halpin again putting that one just over the top of Markowski for the advancing Olympic attacker. You just see the flight of the ball bending nicely towards the striker. A difficult one for the defenders to deal with as the ball tends to move away from you.
Good work from Halpin to get in front of his man. used the blindside run from his fellow striker, and then they got in front of the defender, put his header wide.
Chris Jackson had done well as well, as we see Clint Bolton almost taking it back into his own goal. But it looks to me as if Clint Bolton there is wearing the captain's armband. So Troy Halpin, not the captain this evening. It's the keeper, Clint Bolton. Here's Nata. Nobody in support for Harry Nata. He had nobody making a move down this left flank to deliver the ball to, and eventually was outnumbered and muscled off the ball.
Now the times you've got to get players forward, and you know, got a talented left-sided player now with the re-signing of Jeff Campbell, and that was surely an opportunity for him to leave his marker, get forward and support Harry Nata.
He's playing very deep, Jeff Campbell. He's playing more as a left back than anything else. But we haven't seen him venture over the halfway line too often. Here is Campbell. The challenge is made on North. And he gets the throw in, Campbell.
Likewise on the other side, Gordon. You've got Jonathan Perry dropping very deep. So in effect, you're playing a 5-3-2 formation. And the long run from the back there to try and get in support for the front players, for the wing-backs. I think maybe it's a case of, you know, we'll try and hold it nil all for a while, get our feet on the ground, and then maybe later on in the game try and push players forward and try and snatch a win.
Burton. Again, needs to hold possession while he gets some support. Now Campbell. Nice play through Wilson's leg. Jeff Campbell, good cross in. Perry coming in at the back post, couldn't make contact. Gonsalves might recover it. Cross comes back in. Campbell have to fight to keep that one in and can't do so. We saw a little bit of skill that Jeff Campbell's capable of.
He's done them all ends up there. Great delivery in. And Jonathan Perry trying his best to get in from the far side to finish it off. It's great work from Jeff Campbell there.
Well read by Markoski. Halpin. North popping up on both sides of the park. Jake North, we've seen him down this right flank as well. Packer. North. Halpin. Looking to help it on. Bozeski had come far too close. And Markoski maybe settling into his role in the centre of defence. He read that play very, very well. Cut out the pass. Was on his way before the Olympic player had even passed the ball.
There's been times too where he's quite happy to drop across and take the left-hand side stopper position, and Sean Douglas.
No flag. Albert keeps it low. Well, they stood and they hoped the flag from the official on this near side would go up. It didn't. And Halpin had plenty of time to line up the shot, and the Kings were saved by the crossbar.
Here again, that opportunity has come from just people at the back not knowing what each other are doing. John Markovsky got pulled out of position. He was playing down the left. Sean Douglas had gone into the middle. Chris Jackson out right. And they just didn't pick up help in coming through. And that's pure and simple, just lack of organisation at the back.
Perry gets the ball back from Gonsalves. Erlovich feeds off it.
Yeah, well, Halpin just peels away, gets himself some freedom, just pulled the trigger on this one, and that had the keeper all ends up. So the crossbar coming into play. I think, as you say, Fred, it's just that interchanging of players at the back that they've got to be careful of. They're isolating space and allowing the Olympic Sharks to get their free midfield players into it. It's causing them some problems.
Well, it's difficult for the defenders, because You've got Carl and Basevski dropping into midfield, and straight away that puts doubt on their mind. Should I go with them? Should I stay and hold my position? And then if you've got midfielders coming into the gaps that are left by those players, you know, you've got that added thing of should I pick him up, or is a midfielder going to pick him up?
Carl. Nick Carl. Well seen by Theokotos. But Wilson and Carl had led the Kings a merry dance down in this left corner. Berlovich will get the free kick. North obstructing the Kings player.
It was all a little bit messy at the back here, and Nick Carl getting himself involved again. Drags this one back past Sean Douglas and looks to play to the near post.
A great turn on him. Nick Carl just shows the ball, the defender overcommits and just drags it back past him. We've seen that on a number of occasions already tonight. Just beautiful footwork.
So Campbell to take the free kick. Easy for Bolton. Very easy for the 25-year-old, former Brisbane player. But Zolas, Campbell loses out. Packer, but Zolas comes back to help out. Burton, time to turn if he could bring it down. Referees wave play on. Packer. So we've had half an hour at Ericsson, still 0-0. Bozeski.
Oh.
Everybody stood and watched it, even the Olympic players. Halpin, Wilson, Carl. Halpin going on the overlap. Well, that was an incredible period of play with the cross coming over, and everyone in the black shirt, everyone in the white shirt stood like statues.
Yeah, it was really just a matter of somebody picking up the responsibility there, and the opportunity could have come the way of the Sharks, but again helping Freddie. I mean, he's appeared on the left hand side, then he's on the right hand side. You know, he's really pulling the strings tonight for the Sharks,
and he's wanting things to happen. He's trying to make things happen. And I mean, for Sydney Olympic, sorry, Olympic Sharks, I'll get it right by the end of the night.
You will get it right.
you know, he's the guy they look to when they're in trouble. Give it to Troy and we'll see what happens.
Perry. Nata. Burton just got a foot in it, but it's left a big gap with Douglas down and Carl down, and Douglas is struggling to get back. Well, Nick Carr has been in the wars on the halfway line. So has Sean Douglas, who managed to get back to try and help his defence. That's Nick Carr who's gone down. Sean Douglas is down on his haunches as well.
Could well be one of those that you always feared getting, Freddie. But this was a little bit lucky for the Olympic Sharks. They've gone in for a challenge here, Douglas and Cal. We can all see where that one's made contact. And the ball fell quite nicely for the Sharks to get away and break.
I think Sean Douglas just twisted his knee as he went into that challenge. But by committing himself there in the ricochet, gave Wilson the freedom of the park down the right-hand side.
And one other thing too, Gordon, on that Douglas tried to recover and got held back by one of the Olympic players. A little bit of confrontation on the way back. And they had a word with each other once the ball had gone dead.
It's fortunate for the Kings that Wilson took such a bad option there, because if he held the ball up, there were a number of Olympic players coming through trying to get into the Kings penalty area.
Michael Theokotos, who picked up three bookings in his first three matches, was heading for a suspension with one more, has kept the tidy record since then. Missed a couple of games when he was dropped for James Bannatyne, who's on the reserves bench this evening. but has come back and has really made the goalkeeping spot his own. This man knows a bit about goalkeeping though. 219 games in the NSL. And rated very, very highly. Probably the best there is playing in Australia. Of course, the Australians have a few keepers playing overseas. We see a lovely bit of skill from Ante Juric. Huge man, but to skip between Gutsoulis and Vlahos with ease.
And now he's on the right fullback position.
Now he's going for the centre forward position. Pondoyak looks for the run at Carl, and that must have been very close.
I tell you what, he would have been on the end of that cross from Carl as well.
Yeah, that's the beauty of having a sweeper who's prepared to go forward and carry on going forward. As the ball comes through, Pondoyak slips it through just a metre in it. But again, Carl trying to get on the end of that ball. Great build-up play from Olympic.
So 10 minutes till half-time. There's no goals at Ericsson. Olympic will certainly feel they deserve one at least. They have dominated this half without threatening the Kings' goal on too many occasions, clear-cut occasions, that is. But we have seen Troy Halpin rattle the bar. And the Kings have yet to really test Clint Bolton in the Olympic goal. Now Jade North popping up on the right side. Halpin. Paul Kohler, another ever-present this season, hasn't missed a match. Jackson giving it away to Pondoyak, putting the defence under some pressure. Pondoyak, still the Kings can't get a foot in. Here's Wilson. Pondoyak gets a touch on. Nata clears his lines. And it's all just a bit rushed for the Kings, you feel. There's no composure out there. Needs somebody to really control things in the middle of the park.
I think they just have to get the ball and hold on to it. Play a bit of possession football if they can. Work really hard on the ball. And you know, give the guy who gets the ball a lot of support and a lot of options. Just try and play themselves into the game. It's all a bit sporadic.
Durante in the inside left channel. Good tackle from Perry. Now a chance for Jackson. Looks to unleash Vlahos with a good ball. Needs support. Burton's racing into the middle. Here comes Mark Burton. Paul Kohler did well. Burton was the only Kings player heading for the box. Vlahos, bit short for Gutsoulis. She does well. Nata.
Good ball.
Good ball out to Campbell. Needs a good cross. The Kings don't even get a corner, which frustrates Mark Burton.
Much better play by the Kings, and you know, just players getting into positions to support going forward. And a great run there by Jeff Campbell to get wide on the left-hand side. Great first-time ball from Harry Nader out of the middle of the park. He knew he'd be there this time. He's dropped it out there. Jeff's got forward. And as the deliveries come in, as you said, Gordy, a little bit frustrated that nothing came of it. But, you know, good to see players being prepared to put themselves into those quality positions.
The Okotos outside of the boot. Douglas starting to get into the game now. Hasn't played since round four with that hamstring problem. Perry. Heavy first touch from Perry.
Vlahos for me is the one that they need to find when they get forward, Freddie. I think if they can get over the halfway line, find him in some space, he's certainly a player to create.
I think they have to also just have to pick their moment to go forward. I think that last instance, it was Chris Jackson had the ball. There actually wasn't really much need to go forward there because there weren't that many Kings players forward. They could have just sat on the ball, played it square, played it back, and then looked to go forward as they put players there. Well, it just seems that they get rushed into playing forward and then they lose it quickly, and then straight away they're on the back foot and the wing backs are dropping back to pick up their men. So the whole time they're in a defensive frame of mind because they haven't got the ball.
A little over 5 minutes remaining in the first half, 0-0 at Ericsson. Durante. That should be easy for the keeper. Burton. Perry. Lajos getting taken out by Jake North, who in turn gets taken out by Mark Burton, and the official on the far side gave that to the Kings, and Mark Burton has been booked for the challenge on Jake North. Not often you see Mark Burton getting on the wrong side of referees.
I think a little bit of tit for tat there. I think the Kings probably quite rightly should have got a free kick before this incident.
I think Jade North milked this a bit though, Ricky.
Yeah, it's all got pretty tight on the side as North gathers this one on the touchline. Mark Burton's come, I would say, pretty late. I'm not sure he's made any contact with him. He's jumped. I think it was just the way he approached him that probably the referee coming from behind. Although the linesman did indicate with his flag.
Halpin with the free kick. Carr. Nata. Nice play. Campbell finds Vlahos. Leaves it a bit short for Jeff Campbell. Vlahos gets it back, and he's dangerous in these positions, Andy Vlahos. Well, he scored from a similar range against Newcastle just before Christmas. That was a bit too direct, a bit too close to the keeper. But it was good build-up play from the Kings down the left side.
Yeah, well done. I think just that combination. I mean, Jeff Campbell just with the re-signing again, we've touched on that one, but the players will get to know that he has got quality going forward and can deliver, and that's going to free Andy Vlahos up a little bit from having to cross in from the left-hand side. And a good little combination there that finished with a shot on goal.
There again, I think Andy Vlahos, he always looks his most dangerous as he drifts wide to pick up the ball.
Charge from Markowski, almost embarrassing Bolton. I don't know if he intended it as a shot, but Bolton, a couple of yards off his line, had to be alert to the danger it offered. Juric. Long loping run over the halfway line. North. Pondoljak. Halpin. So a couple of minutes on the clock in this first half. Still no score. But the last few minutes have looked better for the Kings. Carl trying to hold off Jackson. Jackson does well to get a foot in. Here's Burton. Nata on the overlap. And the Kings would have been away if Nata had managed to find
fantastic.
Burton. Here's Bozeski. Cuts inside. Can't find some space. Carl. Good defending.
It's good patient defending, and I think the players have adjusted now. They know what Cal's going to do, and they're quite happy to stay on their feet. They haven't dived in, and certainly inside the box there, it's important that they're patient.
Great kick on the edge of the box. The challenge on Carl from Jackson. And this could be a dangerous time for the Kings. A minute till half time.
Here again, I don't think it's the actual challenge, but just the way he goes in. He's gone in with his right leg, so it's all looked a bit clumsy. And it's given Olympic Sharks a great opportunity just before half time.
To Pondelyak and Halpin to try to break the deadlock at Ericsson. The Okatosh trying to see if he can see the ball. It's Halpin. Oh, it's a good save from the Okatosh. Saw it all the way and cleared away for a corner.
But he's taken responsibility. He's got the wall lining up the right-hand side for himself. He's taken the left-hand side and played his part again. Great save by the keeper.
2 extra minutes of added time. Carl swings it in. Another corner. Carl again to swing this one in. Markowski given the task of challenging Juric. Lilovic back doing defending. In fact, every Kings player back in their own penalty area. Pondelyak stands at the ball, manages to get up and recover without a Kings player making a challenge. Carl. Wilson, Bozeski, can't find Nick Carl, and the Kings able to relieve some of the pressure with this free kick as they try and count down the clock to half time. Chris Jackson working very, very hard in defence, the new look defence, which has done okay in the first 45 minutes at Ericsson. Maybe a late opportunity for the Football Kings. Packer. The referee, I'm sure, will think about calling the half to an end any second. Still no score. Troy Halpin's shot against the crossbar. The nearest we've come to a goal. Also, the recent free kick that was clawed away by Michael Theokotos, who's made a couple of good saves in this first half. Early on from Nick Carl. And then that free kick save just a moment or so ago. And there is the halftime whistle at Ericsson. Been a pretty dour first half. Olympic perhaps have shaded it in possession and in dominance, and maybe will think themselves unlucky not to be a goal up at halftime. But as the players leave the field for the halftime break, it's the Football Kings 0, Olympic Sharks 0. Score at Ericsson on a very pleasant evening in Auckland. Olympic Sharks have certainly had more of the possession, I would say, in this first half. And we just look at the match statistics, and certainly shots on goal and shots on target have favoured the Olympic Sharks, and in the possession stakes much the same. Probably pretty unlucky, the Olympic Sharks. They haven't really taken advantage of that first half possession and the advantage of the shots on goal to maybe lead this game.
Yeah, I think probably from Gary Phillips' point of view, he'll be disappointed. I spoke to him prior to the match, and you know, he sort of felt that this year the side had dominated most of the games, except for a 45-minute period of the second half against Marconi Stallions. But again tonight, you know, four shots should be enough at this level to perhaps have bagged one and set them on away for another 3 points. But in fairness, the Kings have come out tonight sort of a little bit more fired up than what we've seen, much more organised at the back, and against a side that has struggled to score.
I'm trying to think whether that King's shot on target was the John Markowski hoof from halfway that...
Andy Vlahos scored.
Actually, it should be two.
Should be two.
That was on target.
That was on target to the John Markowski one. So not a bad crowd turned out at Ericsson for a match 4 days into the new year. Hopefully some new luck for the Football Kings. They certainly have been down on their luck this season. We expected so much from the Kings in 2001, 2002 to push on from their two eighth place finishes, as Andy Vlahos and Paul Ulevich lead the Kings players out for the second spell. Block five. They haven't deserted the Kings, even though they are bottom of the table. Well, Fred, looking at my statistics, if there's going to be a goal, it's going to come in the next 35 minutes, because the Kings, of the 17 they've scored this season, or 13 have come in this period after half time.
I think the key thing is that the Kings are still in the game. You know, I mean, last game against Adelaide, they were well out of it. 5 minutes into the second half, 3-0 down. They went in 2-0 down, so it's a marked improvement tonight. And if they can just hold on again and maybe get a little bit more going forward, then maybe the 3 points are there for them.
Andy Vlahos, he probably expected a lot more when he came across the Tasman beginning of the season. Jeff Campbell had no luck at Adelaide in his spell there this year. Comes back to the Kings and goes straight into the starting lineup. Harry Nata, who's been in and out of the side this season, but I think is certainly Mr. Reliable, and the Kings play better when he's in the centre of the midfield. So it'll be the Olympic Sharks to kick off in the second spell, playing from right to left. And these two men have shown in the first 45 minutes that they are a handful. Shane Roofer and Kevin Fallon sitting together at the start of the second spell, deciding on their tactics. The second half underway at Ericsson. No score between the side in fourth, the Olympic Sharks, and the side in 13th, the Football Kings. Burton. Campbell. Difficult ball for Vlahos to make any use of. Well, the Kings didn't really offer a lot going forward in the first half, but we have seen in the odd match this season that the start of the second half, they have shown a resurgence, especially in the last two home games here, in the loss to Northern Spirit and the 2-2 draw against Newcastle. It was that period just after half-time they came out firing.
Yeah, I think the critical thing for the Kings tonight, Gordy, was to make sure they got the back three organised and the defensive side of it right. They've done that, and as Freddie's touched on, they've got themselves well in the match at the halfway stage. Now it's an opportunity to go and build from that. The previous match against Adelaide was all over. They didn't have an opportunity to come out and change it. Tonight they do.
Still think it's important they sit in for 10 minutes and get back into the game. And then from there, push on and look for a goal. But don't just come out after half-time and go hell for leather for a goal, because probably Sydney Olympic Sharks are thinking the same thing.
You could be fine tonight.
I spent 20 years calling them Sydney Olympic.
Markowski just getting a knock on the top of the foot from Troy Halpin and wins the free kick. Markowski will take his own free kick. Douglas Erlevich. Jade North paying close attention to Paul Erlevich. Koski again read that well. Saw the danger looming, was over to snuff it out. Wozeski. Wilson. Packer in the box. Perry does well. It'll be a corner. So a good bright start to the second half by the Sharks.
Good tracking from Jonathan Perry as well. His man's come from deep and he's followed him all the way. Made sure he stayed between himself and the goal and heads that one away for the corner.
So Halpin with the corner. Ante Juric has gone forward to make a nuisance of himself. He beats the ball and cleared by Perry again. The Kings back defending in numbers. All 11 back in their own penalty area. Pondoljak. North making a run down the centre forward channel and nobody really picked him up until very late. Well, Jake North's been a lively character. He's popped up on the left back, right back, and now it's centre forward.
We've seen a few of those tonight. But shades of the old Brazilian side, Gordon.
Total football, they call it, don't they?
Total football.
Whereas every player can play in every position. Ante Juric, who'd come from centre back to centre forward while playing right wing at one stage in the first half. So they're certainly confident in their ability, the Olympic Sharks players.
I think it's an attractive brand of football too, and I think that's what the supporters at the Olympic Sharks really do enjoy. And as long as it's positive and safe and it gets results.
That's the key though, Rick. If it gets results.
If it gets results, Freddie.
I think the Kings tried that in the first few games under Mike Peterson. And we know what results came that way.
Halpin. Wozeski. He's been a good acquisition for the Olympic Sharks. Nick Wozeski making his first appearance on the team sheet tonight for Olympic. Durante. Pondoljak. Wilson. He's found him. Good run from the right wing back. Chance for Carl. Swing and a miss. Packer. Closed down by the black shirts. Now Pondoljak. Halpin. Well, the Kings are defending en masse. And it works. Erlevich. Wilson will get the free kick. Maybe asking the referee for a bit of action in his pocket on Andrew Durante. Well, there's been a lot of talk about those two, Shane Roofer and Kevin Fallon, falling out. That picture would tell a different story. Sitting together on the bench. So Vlahos with this free kick for the Kings. Chance for Erlevich! Oh, drags his header wide. Well, the goal was gaping. Erlevich just had to get it on target, but a good start for the second spell for the Kings. And Erlevich almost adding to his six goals this season.
Well, there's a great ball in from Andy Vlahos. Paul Erlevich just comes around the back of the three big Olympic defenders to find himself free. And
should have scored.
Should have scored, Freddie.
If that had been the Kings who had been defending on that occasion, we'd have been slating them because that was poor from Olympic. A big hole opened up. Bolton was nowhere. Ante Juric had fallen over. And Paul Erlevich almost stole a goal.
Good run from Paul. They went in, checked back out, got free, But yeah, he'll be disappointed. He'll be gutted with that header.
A couple of quality runs off the ball as well.
There were three of them going in, and Paul was the back one, and he's just checked out. He's taken the three defenders in, and you know, should have been a goal. So well worked free kick, and great delivery from Andy Vlahos.
Carl gets the free kick for the nudge in the back from Campbell.
Watch Paul Ilovich go in, goes in with the three, just checks out, and he's free. And you've got to put those away, Paul.
Well, Olympic have kept four clean sheets this season. To keep them another one tonight, we'll pick up some points. Halpin skips away from Gitsoulis. Troy Halpin, easy for Theokotos.
It was a wee bit disappointing after the enterprising run by Troy Halpin.
Well, the Kings are getting back in numbers. Every man is helping out. Here's Gitsoulis. He can hit that.
Been end-to-end stuff. Mark Burton just lobbing the ball. Andy Vlahos getting onto it with the header, and Gonzalez just finding himself with a little bit of space. Zurich hadn't closed him down. Bolton Bennett is near post. He'll be disappointed with that effort, but a great strike from Gonzalez.
It's good when the ball's on a volley, George. I mean, we've seen a lot of his shots when the ball's on the ground. He tends to sky them wide, but when the ball's on the volley, he makes sweet contact. Here we see Vlahos gets up, ball sits up nicely. As you say, Ricky, the keeper's going to be disappointed with that. Should have had that covered. I think it was an unexpected shot for him. I was expecting him to take it down and maybe take the player on or pass into the centre of the field, but just caught on the near post. That's bad goalkeeping. But again, a wonderful strike from George Gutsoulis.
Well, I said, Fred, you expect any goals will come in this period just after half-time. Kings again.
Nostradamus.
The stat man pulls it out again.
That's their 14th goal scored in this period of the game this season. And I'm sure the word coming from the bench from Kevin Fallon and Shane Roofer is what we've got, we hold.
I think what was great about that goal too, it's come from the midfield player and playing three in there tonight with Gutsoulis, Nader and Burton. It's encouraging to see that one of them's got forward.
Well, Greg Owens is on for Nick Bozevsky for Olympic in the first change in the game. Well, now we'll see what's happened over the Christmas holiday period, whether the Kings can hold on to this lead. Well, this Olympic team are rated one of the best in the league, so this will certainly open up the game, I'm sure. And we'll make Olympic come at them. They've had a topsy-turvy season so far. The Olympic Sharks, as Halpin is allowed to run a long way. Here's Owen. Douglas. Burton.
Straight away you see more urgency in the Olympic team, pushing players forward. It's up to the Kings to weather the storm for the next 5 or 10 minutes. And then maybe push on as Olympic chase the game, push on and try and sneak another goal and make it safe.
Mark Burton really caught in two minds about what to do. Now Markowski caught out with the ball behind them to Owens. Juric coming forward, blocks his chances. Markowski nice and cool. He plays it out of the fence. Lajos out number 2-1. Burton gets it back to the Kings. Just played it a bit short to Erlovich. Now this game has got a bit more open feel about it. Perry. They've got 8 games at home, the Kings, including this one, in the remainder of the season, and they've really got to make them count. They've picked up just the 2 points so far at home. The 2 draws, 0-0 against South Melbourne, and 2-2 against second place Newcastle. A game they probably feel they should have won. Leading deep into injury time. Lots of questions asked about the amount of added time in that game. But Newcastle, to their credit, retained their unbeaten record by scoring at the death in that game in the 2-2 draw. The Kings can't really afford to sit back and allow Olympic to come at them, though, for the final half an hour.
I think it's a time now, really, for the Kings to just relax, keep knocking the ball away, around, and when they've scored themselves a good goal, it's not a time to panic.
Well, certainly, John Markowski's got a voice barking out the orders from the back. Carl. Nice play to find Jake North. Good save again from Theocritus. Well, we're right behind that in the commentary box, and I could see this big gap opening up at the left-hand post. But Theocritus got down well and palmed it away. Carl. Halpin. Wilson. We'll get the corner.
And what you'll see in the next passage of players, a lot of Sydney Olympic players running at the Kings' defence. The shot comes in and Theocritus covers his angles well and parries it away.
Away from Douglas. Only Vlahos has stayed forward. Burton. Erlovich is in big space on the right-hand side, and that's what Burton's looking for. McCooper to stay between the defender and the keeper. Perry. They have to keep it going at pace, the Kings. Campbell. Gonzalez, the goal scorer. Vlahos just muscled off the ball in the challenge. Wilson. Well, Ante Juric went down quickly, got the free kick. Wasn't much in the challenge from Jackson. He's a workaholic, Chris Jackson. Up there making the challenge and quickly back into position in the defence. So Halpin with the free kick. Half an hour remaining at Ericsson. That'll be easy for the keeper. Well, the Kings have weathered the 5 minutes or so after the goal very, very well.
Yeah, they certainly have, and I think their counter-attacks have been more productive tonight. It'd be just good to see them go forward and perhaps contain the ball up in their attacking third just a little bit longer than what they have done, just to take a little bit of pressure off the back. Markowski, as you said, Gordon, is doing a great job at the back. He's marshalled his defenders, and it's important now that he gets Gutsalis and Harry Nata doing good jobs in the middle of the park. Because as Olympic Sharks push players forward, those two players are going to come into the game a lot more.
And also, the longer the game goes on, you know, he's not the fittest player in the world, Markowski. And when you're trying to organise and marshal other players, fitness is a key thing, because you know, you've got to stay alert. And as he gets tired, probably his ability to do that will drop. So it's important that the other players around him, you know, pick up a lot of the slack.
So the throw will be for the Kings, down in the bottom corner. Carr. Get another throw, this time it'll be for the Sharks. Owens. holds off Markowski, Pondoljak, Juric making lots of runs forward, Ante Juric, and it's a corner. The referee saw a slight deflection off a Kings player, and you just see there the part of the anatomy that it touched on the way past the Okotos' goal. So it'll be a corner for Olympic. Lots of talking going on in the Kings defence. Halpin with the responsibility of the corner. Every Kings player back defending. And they've left it for Packer. Lajos. Handball, it looked like. And it's been given, the referee's got to book Durante for a deliberate handball. So the second player to go on the referee's notebook. Andrew Durante for a deliberate handball.
Yeah, not sure I totally agree with that. When Andy Vlahos had put the ball up, there wasn't a lot of Kings players in forward positions to go forward to. I think he was just looking to play that down the line.
I'm with the referee on that one, Ricky. Good
but
decision.
But you're the stat man, you need to do.
Oh, I think
stat
it was
man or train spotter.
Oh, yeah, it was deliberate handball to just to slow down the attack.
He's in Hamilton on holiday.
It's where it happens, Ricky.
So Andy Durante now walks the tightrope. Douglas. Must admit, they're looking at the stats. If we get to the last 10 minutes, the Kings have conceded 9 this season in the last 10, so that must be a worrying period for them.
As we said in the last game, I think Gordon, the last home game, when they scored to go ahead, I thought they scored a bit early. Because there were more than 3 minutes to go.
Ehrlich with a good run down the inside left channel. Burton, good solace in the box. So have Lajos and Perry if the cross can come in. And they'll go for goal kick. So they're don't look happier, but I'm sure they must be a little more content inside that their side had the lead against one of the top teams. Carl turns away from his defender. Gutzolas just getting in the way. Ehrlovic has to hold up play. Vlahos, Ehrlovic and Burton going forward. Vlahos just showed a bit too much to Juric and he's gone down in a heap. And his teammate puts it out so he can receive some attention. Seemed a rather innocuous challenge. Zurich taking a crack on the top of the boot.
Yeah, Vlahos just going forward with the ball here and didn't really look a lot in it there, although it might have just caught him on the top of the foot. Oh, got that one right, Fred.
The magic spray. Ante Zurich. 28-year-old, made his NSL debut in 1993. So he's going to have to go off to put his boot back on, so Olympic will be down to 10 men for a moment or two while he receives further attention. Wilson, Nice layoff. Nata, good strong challenge in the centre of the park, but Gonzalez gives away the ball unnecessarily. Wilson. Wilson gets away from Campbell. Greg Owens. Kohler. Erlovich, Flava still in the run, he could have watched this from the offside. Erlovich, the head is just a bit too strong though. Well, he almost made something of it, Paul Erlovich. Andy Vlahos was perhaps the pass he should have made. But in the end, he almost got through on goal.
I think his first touch just let him down there. The initial ball just bobbled away too far. Andy Vlahos made a good run across the defence, trying to head out to the right flank. And Paul Erlovich trying to recover from his mistake. Ended up getting a bit too much head on it.
Rowan's done well to shake off the challenge from Sean Douglas.
I think the combination of Paul Erlovich and Andy Vlahos is getting better as they're playing more and more games together. They're running off each other well. You see there, they flick on by Vlahos. Paul Erlovich just in behind, just instinctively knowing that's where it's going, just picks up the scraps.
Pondoliak. Bit too fancy in the middle of the park.
And now I think it's important, if you've got that combination up front going, it's the third player, Burton, Gutsiulis, Harry Nata, that's got to join that attack.
Nata. Vlahos. Burton. Nice control from Burton. He's got Wilson back challenging. He's done a power of work down that right-hand side, Lindsay Wilson. Campbell. Gutsiulis. Just keeping possession, the Kings. Burton. Vlahos. Vlahos going for the exchange. And the Kings may have got a throw. It looked like it was a Kings throw. The referee saw it differently though.
Well, it's a good passage of play there from the Kings. Quite happy to keep it. Quite patient. Got themselves into a forward position.
Exactly. Just a bit of patience on the ball. I mean, it's important not to overplay it, but they hold the ball 5-10 passes every time you get it. Forces Olympic Sharks to chase the ball, and they're the ones that have to chase the game. So the more you hold on to it, the more frustrated they're going to get.
20 minutes remaining, and the Kings lead Olympic Sharks by a goal to nil. The goal by George Gutsiulis, 8 minutes into the second spell. Halpin. Carl. Good run from Wilson. Good ball across. It was the long legs of George Gutsiulis that got the Kings out of a spot of bother, because Packer was lurking to level the scores. Zurich. Cowell taking another deflection, but the Kings, is the referee has awarded the goal kick.
Yeah, at times it's just putting your body on the line, and we've seen a couple of occasions now where defenders have gone to ground and got deflections and taken the ball away from going on target, which is a real must when they're just absorbing a little bit of pressure now coming from the Sharks.
Erlovich needs support. Delivered well to Campbell, who's put it in first time. A few spots of rain at Ericsson now. Don't think it's going to caused too many problems. The ground is very, very firm underfoot. Here's Carl. Got a yard of space. Reflex save from the keeper. Well, we've talked about Theokotos all season when it comes to making saves. Reflex saves like that one. He's very, very good.
Well, one thing the Sharks will be disappointed with tonight is that when they've got shots on target and the keeper's parried them away, they haven't had players there to follow up and get the tap-ins.
North and Vlahos tussling over the ball. Oh, almost! The blunder of the season from Clint Bolton. Well, what was the Olympic keeper thinking? And Paul Erlovich almost added to his tally this season in the most unexpected way.
Bet the keeper's heart was in his mouth there. That piece of footage would have gone worldwide, I think.
North. The Kings have certainly shown that what they do have, they are going to try and hold on to as much as possible. And they could have increased their lead with the blunder of the season from Clint Bolton.
Well, it's not often you see it, but you do see it. And Bolton just playing completely square across his goal mouth. Paul Erlovich, I guess, half expecting it, making contact on it. I mean, perhaps anywhere else on the body that would have gone in.
Jeff Campbell's off, Gerard Davis is on. Jeff Campbell settled back into his role with the Kings very well this evening. And that'll be a straight swap. Davis will take up the duties down that left-hand side. Douglas. ...15 minutes remaining. The Kings still lead by a goal to nil. Carr. Olympic come into this match with just the one win. A big win it was, 3-1 over Perth Glory. One win in their last four. A couple of losses and a draw in the mix as well.
I think one thing Gary Phillips, looking back on this match, will be disappointed with is the way that the Olympic Sharks strikers haven't run at John Markowski. I think they've been prepared to run at the defence, but to isolate him and run at him and try and expose him in his first match as a defender, it's one of the more difficult things to come to grips with. I think they haven't done that on enough occasions to get some mileage out of it.
Vlahos was the only player staying forward. He's now gone back to join his other 10 teammates in the penalty area. Here's Carl, closed out quickly by Jackson, and they'll get another corner. Well, that's the new defensive strategy of them boys. Everybody back, and it certainly worked so far.
Everybody back and get anything in the way.
Well, that's a telling statistic. 9-0 in corners for Olympic. They have dominated everywhere apart from on the score sheet. And those statistics, at corners, shots on target, won't worry Kevin Fowne and Shane Roofer if the Kings get out of this with a 1-0 victory. Halpin. Again, the white tide comes rolling back at the Kings. Carl. Pondoyak. Halpin. Kings can't go to sleep now. Owens. One hand went up for offside, wasn't given, and the attack peters out.
Well, the Sharks, being 1-0 down, quite happy to play their normal brand of football. They're not going to change at this stage, and knocking it around. Not prepared to have a shot from long range and trying to work things through the middle of the Kings' defence, which is how very, very strong tonight.
And they're trying to get in behind, but they're... They're doing a lot of their interpassing in front of the defence. And they need that ball that just splits the defence open.
Here's Pondoyak. The ball just stood up on him a bit. And he couldn't take it in his stride. Jackson working like a terrier for his team. He's managed to retrieve possession. Urlovich has to hold the ball. Jackson gets clattered by Andrew Packer. And it's got to be at least a booking. But it might be even more. Well, that was born out of frustration, I think, from Andrew Packer. And Chris Jackson wouldn't have seen it coming.
It would have been interesting if the referee, he had a good look to see what happened to the ball, because it went to Andy Vlahos, who was one-on-one with his with the last defender. It would have been quite interesting to see if the referee had let that one go and done the booking afterwards. Andy Vlahos was a bit frustrated by the sound of the whistle there.
He's worked very hard this evening, Jackson. You're feeling a bit sore, I'm sure, after that challenge.
He certainly won't be one to be wanting to go off at this stage. He's had a very solid game back there tonight.
Koski hoofs it forward. Davis gets the throw. Fallon off his seat on the bench. Halpin. 10 minutes remaining at Ericsson. A dangerous period for the Football Kings. Cal skips away from Jackson and Perry. Chance now. Owens skips round one. Owens! Puts his shot over Theopatos' bar. Well, it looked easier to score.
Certainly hasn't been a great line in front of goal for the Sharks, and Greg Owens gets himself into a great position here. Cuts back inside Gutsalis, gets the rebound again just to see the open goal. Keeper well beaten. And that one sails high over the crossbar.
Well, maybe there's a bit of luck for the Kings as Campbell Banks comes on for Mark Burton. Maybe that sums up tonight's games. They've had their chances, the Sharks. They haven't converted any so far. Maybe, just maybe, the Kings' luck has turned. So now it'll be Urlovich and Banks who play up front, with Andy Vlahos having that free roll just in behind them, I'm sure. It's an attack you liked before kickoff, Ricky.
Yeah, I'd like to see Urlovich and Banks playing up there. Vlahos just a little free roll. He can operate on the left and right hand side.
As we move into these final 9 minutes, the frustration, I'm sure, will start to get to the Olympic players. a game they have dominated. And it's a game they are losing.
Twan, I think when they arrived, they would obviously have expected to take all 3 points.
Flag's got up for offside against Wilson.
On the other hand, for the Kings, I mean, to be winning 1-0 against the fourth place team in the league, when you're bottom of the league, I mean, that's just a fantastic result. If they can hold out here, I mean, that would just be tremendous for the club.
Banks working hard on Juric. Every Kings player is working very hard. They're working for each other. Now Bolton, this time he clears his lines properly. Well, he reads the game very well, I think, Markowski in that position. Certainly knows how a striker would think. But when he clears his lines, there's no messing around, is there?
There again, he's not putting the ball at risk, is he?
Wilson.
Cannot accuse him of that.
Taken on Banks. I've been impressed with Lindsay Milson. Packer. Touch back. Carl can't keep it down. Another one goes begging. He can't believe it.
It was a classy move, really. I mean, Wilson, as you said, Gordon, getting down the right-hand side. And we see the Olympic Sharks 18 opportunities with shots on goal to the Kings 7. But it's Wilson again getting down the right-hand side. Great ball in here to the advancing striker. Another little flick. And Nick Carl, probably not onto his favourite foot.
When you think back on the game, there's very few opportunities that Olympic have created down the left. I think most of it's come from Wilson down the right.
Wilson, North, popping up on the right-hand side to get another corner. They must be into double figures now for corners, Olympic. The Kings haven't had one.
The Sharks haven't looked real good on these, though, Gordon, so far.
Well, 5 minutes for the Kings to hang on at Ericsson. They lead by a goal to nil, given to them by George Katsoulis. Just 8 minutes into the second half. Here's Carl. The side! Oh, another wonder save from Theokotos. Well, he's been the man of the match for the Kings, that's for sure. He is a wonderful, wonderful shot stopper.
Well, that certainly came onto the right foot of Nick Carl. He got it on the left-hand side, into the near post. The upwards is reacting really, really well.
Here's Carl. Juric puts it into the melting pot. Oh! And the twilight zone has come back to haunt the Kings. Into that danger period, the last 10 minutes. And Olympic have finally got the goal they so fully deserve, it must be said. But how agonising for the Football Kings.
Well, it's that man again, Nick Carl. Lovely little back heel here. Juric, a delicate little ball, an advancing Sharks attacker. And one can only feel sorry for the Kings goalkeeper. He's had a marvellous game. Some great football here, though, from the Olympic Sharks. And it looks like Troy Helpen from here has climbed above everybody. We'll wait to get that one confirmed, but it looks like Troy Helpen's come out of midfield.
Perry just goal! Goal! And the white shirts are on the ground. And that's an own goal from Andrew Durante.
Well, incredible piece of play. Jonathan Perry just lobs the ball in. The Sharks defender really under no pressure whatsoever. The Goodsalas just rolls this one. Paul Ilovich finds Jonathan Perry in the advancing right-hand position. He plays it in goal bound. but we're certainly not going away empty-handed or disappointed tonight.
Well, what cruel luck for Andrew Durante as he concedes that goal.
And he's just been subbed as well, Gordon.
Caravella coming on. And Paul Cole has gone off as well. But it's all drama at Ericsson. Goals at both ends. And Miyazawa comes on now too. So Elias Demutzidis has come on as well for Olympic. Miyazawa's come on for the Kings. Carl. Run by Halpin. Carl, lovely skill from Carl. Now the Kings, what they've got to hold surely. Banks. Erlich is up in support. Banks has to do all the work though. Chance for the Kings. Cleared up by Packer. North keeps it in for Banks.
Really just looking there for Campbell Banks just to hold the ball up.
Jurich. North. There's a minute on the clock. The Kings lead by 2-1. Gutsoulis gets it away. And the flag has gone up with the referee sitting on infringement. So time running down, but we saw this just before Christmas. Time running out on the clock. We haven't been advised by the official as to how many minutes extra to be added. Banks challenging Packer. Bolton. Caravella. Time up on the clock at Ericsson. But there's going to be 4 minutes of added time. And there has been a couple of stoppages. Here's Pondoyak. Looks to chip Theokotos as he watches it go over his crossbar. So what drama at Ericsson. Lindsay Wilson equalising for Olympic. And then straight away the Kings came charging down the other end. And the shot from Jonathan Perry turned into his own goal by Andrew Durante. And the Kings, who looked to have thrown away the 3 points once again, now have their prize on the golden egg. Banks doesn't get the throw. Pondoyak. No frills from big John Markowski. Anywhere will do, and the crowd loves it. Three minutes of added time still to be played. Perry. Pondoyak. Now a chance, Owens, good tackle, Miyazawa has to clear his lines, only as far as North, and it's far too high.
Well really for the Kings, that's what they wanted, Jade North to have a go from that distance. Wilson had got himself free on the outside and Halpin was not very happy with the decision that he had taken. There was opportunities there to slip the ball wide and get a better delivery in. But that's certainly what the Kings needed.
Sean Douglas went down, bodies on the line. And that's really what is required. They've defended manfully this evening, the Kings, against a team that has dominated possession of the ball and really control of this game. But hey, I'm sure Kevin Fallon and Shane Ruffer will say, who cares? We've got two goals. Olympics got one. That's what they'll say. And at the moment, the Kings have got 3 points, but there's still 90 seconds to play. Have the Kings learned from the tragedy of the Newcastle game just prior to Christmas? 2-1 up, 3 minutes into injury time, and somehow Newcastle walked away with a point.
Well, Markowski there, just happy again, just to roll that ball forward, get it out of play, get the troops organised. Midfield players have dropped back.
Carl, the Kings still have to be alert. A minute on the clock. Good cross in! Theokotos is nowhere! And captain courageous Chris Jackson is in the right spot at the right time. Well, if we've got a criticism of Michael Theokotos, it's on his positional sense, Ricky. He is a fabulous shot stopper, but he does not control his goal area.
Yeah, I mean, it was a great ball in from Wilson. He'd gone on the outside of the defender. He got his hand on that one, and as you said before, Gordon, Chris Jackson just coming across to cover. And a wasted corner opportunity for the Sharks, but surely this one's in the bag for the Kings tonight. Great way to start 2002.
Banks. Perry. I wonder if he'll get credited with that goal that came off Durante's knee. Well, the ball went out and came back in, assistant, but he's given it. Carry on. Gutsolis. We've had 4 minutes of added time. Now Gutsolis. That surely must be it. And the Kings have got their first win under Kevin Fallon. Just their second win of the season. Their first win at home this season. And maybe, just maybe, that will kickstart their season. 2002 has started very, very well for the Kings. Goals. From George Gutsolis. And was it an own goal from Andrew Durante? Has given the Kings the 3 points, their first 3 points at home this season, just their second win, and maybe it's lifted them off the bottom of the table. But it'll be a very, very frustrated Olympic Sharks side who head back to Australia. They've dominated this game in possession. When they look at the stats page, they have clearly been the better team. But nobody in a black shirt will worry about that, as the Kings have beaten one of the top sides in the NSL by 2-1.